lecture, we'll see a small topic of the surgery on hernia. That's the incisional hernia. Incisional hernia. And what will be incisional hernia? The protrusion of viscous or part of viscous, through a weak scar. So incisional hernia is the hernia where the protrusion of the viscous or the part of the viscous through weak scar. Mostly it occurs post operatively. So what happens after the operation, or for the operation, what incision is taken, and when this incision is closed after the operation or surgical process, and when healing of that wound occurs, during that, if the whatever the scar is formed, if that scar remains weak, then there will be a protrusion of the viscous or the part of viscous through this scar. Especially if nerve gets damaged, which causes the paralysis of the muscles or weakening of the muscles, then easily there is a development of the gap in between the muscles and will cause the protrusion of the viscous or the part of the viscous there. Then causes of the incisional hernia divided into groups. One is operative and second post operative scan of incisional hernia, or causes of these are, one is careless suturing of surgical wound. If during the closure of the wound, if the sutures are not carefully done or not closed properly, the scar remains weak, and the latter the protrusion occurs through this scar. Second, involvement of nerves, especially motor nerves, during the surgery. If the motor nerves gets injured during the operation, that will result into the weakening of the muscles or the paralysis of muscles, which causes the protrusion of the viscous or the part of viscous through this wound. Third, the large bore for drain. So what happens after the operation, especially of the abdomen or the cavities, the hole is made for the drainage of the exudates, the fluid that is exuded after the operation wound. The hole is made, and if that hole is large, then it will not be healed properly, the scar will be weak or gap will be there, and protrusion occurs through that hole. So these three are the operative causes, or the causes that which remain during the operation. Post-operative causes, there are two causes are there. One is infection of wound, that is surgical wound. After the operation, if there is infection into the sutures or infection in the wound which is closed after the operation, that infection will make the weak scar formation, and the protrusion occurs through that. Second, overstraining of the abdominal muscles or the muscles over the cavity. This is after the operation or the closure of the wound. The overstraining may be due to cough, constipation, lifting of the weight, that will cause increase in intra-abdominal pressure, and which will lead into the protrusion of viscous or the part of viscous through the weak scar. Do you understood? Most commonly occurs in operation. operations of abdomen. Operations of abdomen. Operations of the abdomen. So usually the weak scar is formed on the abdomen after the operation at the site of the incised wound or wound formed by the incision and leads to the incisional hernia. Types. On the basis of the site, the incisional hernia of the abdominal wall is of the midline hernia. Midline hernia and second one is lateral hernia. Lateral hernia. Midline hernia means the herniation through the midline. Either the supra-umbilical or the infra-umbilical. Mostly the infra-umbilical is there. Mostly infra-umbilical is there because there is a lack of posterior rectus sheath. That's why the infra-umbilical is more common. And this midline hernia, it is a common one type of the hernia, and this hernia has a huge gap through which the viscous or the part of viscous protrude. But this opening has a smooth margin, and this hernia is less dangerous because it usually not become the strangulated. There is no danger of the strangulation in case of the midline hernia. And this hernia disappears on lying down. When patient lie down, this hernia disappears. The hernia which are along with the midline. We understood. The second one is lateral hernia. The hernia which occurs on the sides of the abdomen. Lateral hernia. This type of the hernia in which that the opening through which the viscous or the part of viscous protrude, the hernia sac protrude, is have a narrow opening. And the margins are irregular. We understood. And that's why there are chances of the strangulation. So that's why in this type of the hernia, there is a danger of the strangulation. Sometimes this lateral hernia may becomes irreducible. Will not be reduced on a lying down. So these are the two types of the hernia. Midline incisional hernia and second is the lateral incisional hernia. They understood? Now the treatment. One is prevention. Be conservative. And third is a surgical. Preventive treatment. So whenever patient has been operated for the abdominal problems or when the abdominal surgery is done, the care should be taken. That what? The minimum wound should be made. Small incision should be taken as possible. As then especially during the closure of the wound after the operation should be done properly. The sutures should be taken carefully, layer by layer, close sutures and tight bending, so which will be improves the healing of the wound properly, and then it will make the scar strong and will prevent the herniation. Second, care should be taken that nota nerve should not be injured. We supply to the muscles that we are going to be incised. Third, the small bore should be made. Minimum bores, the small size. The bore should be for draining the wound, that which will create the small gap and small scar will form. And the opening will close properly and harnessing may not work. Prevent the infection with the antibiotics. Patient should be covered with the pre-operative and post-operative antibiotics in any operations. And try to prevent the infections. Then, after every surgical operation, you would advise the patient to don't do the strenuous work, don't lift the weight, or if person have the constipation or the cup, the treatment should be carried out. Even before performing the surgery, if this prevention is taken, the hernia can be prevented. Then the conservative treatment, this is treatment after the occurrence of incisional hernia. Conservative treatment is required, or it can be done in case of the hernia, which midline type of the hernia. Midline hernia, isn't it? and in conjugate treatment, how to use the corset. Use the corset. Corset. The like abdominal vein type on there. So, on the abdomen, first, how to reduce the hernia, either by asking the patient to lie down. If not reduced by lie down, how to reduce by pushing it inside, and the upper corset should be upper on the abdomen. Isn't it? So, that's conjugate. Surgical treatment. The surgical treatment is indication is that if the hernia is not treated with the corset or the conjugate treatment, which one? Midline hernia. And if there is a lateral hernia is there. Usually lateral hernia doesn't treat with the or doesn't completely recover with the corset. So in lateral hernia we require the surgical treatment. Surgical treatment. Then what surgical treatment are there? So three popular methods usually carried out. One is anatomical restoration. Restoration. Second, Mayo's operations. Mayo's operations. Third, approximation of rectus sheath. Rectus sheath. And last, hernioplasty. Hernioplasty. The first one, anatomical approximation or anatomical restoration. See, in anatomical restoration, what should care of? First, open the scar, excise the scar, open the wound, clean it, and the repair the wound layer by layer. Again, repair of the wound. After the wound. Do you are getting it? So in anatomical restoration, first of all, we have to excise the scar, open the wound, and then how to close the wound properly, layer by layer, one after another. Layer by layer, properly with the closed suture. Closed suture. So that's the anatomical restoration. Second, Mayo's operation, as you have done in case of umbilical hernia. Elliptical incision should be made. The umbilical scar should be removed. And after that, you have to expose what? Hernial sac, isn't it? Then incision should be taken on the hernial sac, reduce the content, then the transfix the neck of the sac and dissect out the sac. And then the closure of the wound with the approximation of the rectus muscles. With the rectus sheath. Rectus should keep free from the rectus muscle. So that's a Mayo's operation. Then approximation of the rectus sheath. It mostly carried out in the infra-umbilical hernia, where the rectus sheath is approximated instead of the muscles, the clothes. Here also the rectus should be kept the separate from the underlying rectus muscle. So here we have to close rectus sheath by approximation, which will prevent the recurrence of the hernia. In hernioplasty, you have to repair the hernial opening through which the protrusion gets occurred. It has been reduced as by the Mayo's operation or pressure. After that, the gap or the opening through which that the protrusion was occurred, that should be closed by using the other material, either nylon or proline mesh. Sometimes metal mesh also used. At the opening, this nylon or the proline mesh should be kept, and it will suture with the sheath or the rectus sheath, and hernioplasty should be carried out. Repair of the opening should be carried out by using the other material. It's called the hernioplasty. Then the patient should be covered with what? Antibiotics after the operation. Analgesic should be given there. And patient should be specially advised that to avoid the strenuous work. And even the patient, if you have the cough or the constipation, have to immediately consult with the physician, and the treatment should be taken for the same. This is the incisional hernia. Hope that you understood. This is a small topic which will ask you people for the short notes in the examination. So it is one of the important type of the hard year.